Good morning, all of you. My name is Karthik Kumar, AG. Welcome to Sri Sai Vidya School. And today's session is related to the class 6 in the chapter Oxidation and Reduction. It is the part 2 of oxidation number. In the previous class, we discussed the definition of oxidation number and how we know the oxidation number of the particular element. And what are the rules we have to follow to find the oxidation number of the given element in a given compound. Now it is the part 2 of oxidation number. The topic is oxidation number of radicals. Now what is called a radical? The definition of radical is given as group of atoms with particular charge is known as a radical. Now, what is the major difference between the ion and a radical? Ion represents atomic charge. Ion represents atom with a charge. Now, while taking an example, SO4 minus 2, it is a radical. While taking an example of ion, S power minus 2, it is only one element in the given species, that is S, sulfur, with a charge minus 2. Hence, it is an example of ion. While in case of sulfate, it is an example of a radical. What are the types of radicals? Radicals may be classified into two types: positive radical and negative radical. Positive radical termed as cation, and negative radical termed as anion. Now, cations generally formed by the electro-positive elements. Anions, eligibility given by the electro-negative nature. Cation formed by the metallic character. Element with metallic character has a tendency to form cation. Element with the non-metallic character having the capability to form the anion by gaining of electron. On metallic nature having the capability to the formation of cation by the losing of electron. Now in this session we are going to find the oxidation number of that particular radical and individual atoms in that given radical. Now while taking the first example, that is hydroxide air. The first example is here hydroxide air or hydroxyle air. Now its charge is minus 1. Therefore oxidation number of hydroxyle air is minus 1. Now the emergent element in the given radical is O, oxygen. Then to find the oxidation number of oxygen, we'll get the O, one oxygen atom, one hydride atom equals to the total charge is minus 1. Then you may get O plus hydrogen. In the previous class we discussed that hydrogen shows only plus 1 except in case of metallic hydrides. Now here oxygen is a non-metal, hydrogen is also non-metal. Hence there will be sharing of electron. Sharing of electron always forms hydrogen plus 1. O plus 1 equal to minus 1. Then you may get O equal to minus 2. O equal to minus 2. Nothing but O represents here minus 2. Hence that radical is oxide ion. Now coming to cyanide ion and isocyanide ion. Now in this case, carbon having the valency 4. It is the cyanide radical. Now this one is a isocyanide radical. Carbon having the valency 4, nothing but it can able to form 4 bonds, but nitrogen valency 3, nothing but carbon and nitrogen forms here, carbon and nitrogen forms here, triple bond, and carbon with one lone pair, nitrogen also with one lone pair of electron. Due to the tetravalency of carbon, carbon may exhibit here minus charge, then the total radical may get the Cn minus or Nc minus, depending upon the isocyanide structure. Now in case of carbonate ion, the next radical is carbonate ion. Carbonate ion, it is getting from the carbonic acid. Now carbonic acid on losing hydride atoms H plus, in the form of H plus ion, it may form the conjugate base. Carbonic acid is weak acid, hence carbonate ion is strong conjugate base. Strong conjugate base. Now carbonate ion structures given as, it follows the resonance structure. Due to the alternative double bond C with the valency 4, nothing but O with the second oxygen atom single bond, third oxygen atom also single bond. Now oxygen valency 2, O1 oxygen satisfied, O2 second oxygen atom may form the minus 1, third oxygen atom also may form the minus 1. In the same way, another resonance structure, first oxygen atom minus 1, second oxygen atom double bond, third oxygen atom minus 1. And one more resonance structure for that carbonate ion is C with the double bond with the third oxygen atom, double bond with the third oxygen atom, single bond with the first and second. Then you may get a charge O C O3 power minus 1, you may get the charge minus 2. Now here also minus 1, you may get the charge minus 2. Then first and second oxygen atoms minus 1 and minus 1, you may get the charge minus 2. Then the underlying element in carbonate ion is C. Further, how can we calculate now? Carbon can shows the oxidation number. Now here minus 1, minus 1. Here oxide, minus 2. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 2. Totally get the minus 4. C minus 4 equal to 0. Then carbon may get the charge plus 4. Now here also in the same way, minus 2, minus 1, minus 1. C minus 4 equal to 0, plus 4. Now here also it may get the plus 4. Now in case of bicarbonate ion, bicarbonate ion, bicarbonate ion, another name hydrogen carbonate ion, hydrogen carbonate ion, it is also getting from the carbonic acid, partial replacement of H plus ion. A carbonic acid furnishes in water to give the H plus ion partially, then it may form the bicarbonate ion HCO3 minus, then its charge of the radical is minus 1. Now the underlying element is carbon. Now coming to the structure, C OH O O minus. Now while calculating that the oxidation number of carbon atom, oxide minus 1, hydroxide minus 1, oxide minus 2, then carbon may get the charge plus 4. In the elemental form, how can we calculate now? C plus C plus hydrogen atom plus 1, oxygen atom minus 2 equal to minus 1. C plus 1 minus 6 equal to minus 1. C minus 5 equal to plus 1. C minus 5 equal to plus 1. Then carbon may get the charge plus 4. Now sulfur in case of radicals. Sulfur in case of radicals. First one given as ion and remaining two are radicals. What are the particular names here? Sulfide ion. Sulfide ion. Sulfate ion. sulfate A. All the given species with the valency 2, oxidation number minus 2. Then sulfur individually may get the oxidation number minus 2. In case of sulfide ion, sulfur with 3 oxygen atoms, 3 into minus 2 equal to minus 2, then sulfur minus 6 equal to minus 2, then sulfur may get the plus 4. Sulfur may get the plus 4 in case of sulfide ion. Now in this case, sulfur plus 4 oxygen atoms, 4 of minus 2 equal to minus 2, sulfur minus 8 equal to minus 2, sulfur may get the plus 6. Now based upon the structure also we can show that one, sulfur with 3 oxygen atoms, O, O minus, O minus. Now in this case the total charge will get the minus 2. Oxygen is more electronegative than sulfur. Minus 1, here minus 2. Then sulfur may get the plus 4. Now in case of sulfide ion, yes, double bond with 2 oxygen atoms, single bond with the oxide atoms. Peroxide here, minus 1, and oxide minus 2. Minus 2, minus 2, minus 4, and minus 1, minus 1, minus 2. Minus 4, minus 2. S minus 6 equal to 0, then sulfur may get the charge plus 6. Sulfur may get the charge plus 6. The given charge of the radical is S power minus 2. Now coming to 6th one, that is nitride ion. Nitride ion and NO2 minus is nitride ion. Now while calculating the oxidation number, N plus 3 of minus 2 equal to minus 1, N minus 6 equal to minus 1, N equal to plus 5. Nitride ion charge in nitride ion is nitrate. Now this one is nitride, O2 minus. Now here nitride shows N plus 2 of minus 2 equal to minus 1, N minus 4 equal to minus 1, N equal to plus 3. Nitride radicals. Now coming to oxalate ion, C2O4 power minus 2. Oxalate ion. Now the number of carbon atoms are 2. Each carbon surrounded by 2 oxygen atoms. 1, 2, 1, 2. Here it will be the charge minus 1. Then the overall charge of the radical is minus 2. Hence the oxidation number of oxalate ion is minus 2. Now while comparing oxygen and carbon, which is more electronegative? Oxygen is more electronegative and carbon is less electronegative. Then it may get the charge minus 1, minus 2, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. And with carbon also it may get the minus 1 charge. Then carbon may shows here, tell here, two carbon atoms, minus 8 equal to minus 2, then 2 carbon atoms equal to plus 6, each carbon may get the charge plus 3, minus 1, minus 2, it may get the charge plus 3. Now here also minus 1, minus 2, minus 1 in case of peroxide, minus 2 in case of oxide. Then here also carbon may get the charge plus 3. In case of thiosulfide ion, thiosulfide ion, sulfur underlined element S2O3 power minus 2. Now two sulfur atoms, 3 oxygen atoms. Total charge is minus 2, 2 sulfur minus 6 equal to minus 2, 2 sulfur equal to plus 4 sulfur may get the plus 2 sulfur may get the plus 2. Now in case of nitride ion, as earlier we discussed that in previous class, nitride, now this one is azide ion. Nitride ion, nitride ion shows the minus 3 oxidation number. Here nitrogen shows 3 nitrogen atoms equal to minus 1, and nitrogen here shows minus 1 by 3. Now we can able to calculate the underlying element in the given ionic and covalent compounds, the following given compounds. Now first they given the compound potassium permanganate. It is pink colored salt. Potassium permanganate. It is pink colored salt. It is one of the disinfectant. It is used for the purification method of aquarium. Now it is completely soluble in water. Now in this compound it may get one atom of potassium, one atom of manganese, four atoms of oxygen with the charge, total charge is zero. Now the underlying element is manganese. It is a d block element. Now coming to its charge, potassium, one A group element, due to the group number of potassium, it may get the charge plus 1. And for manganese, we have to find manganese. Oxygen always shows minus 2 in case of oxides. Then 4 of minus 2 equal to 0. Then 1 minus 8, minus 7. Manganese minus 7 equal to 0. Then manganese may get plus 7. Manganese may get plus 7. It is one of the purple salt, dichromate. Dichromate ion. Dichromate ion. Now, number of chromium atoms 2. Chromium is also d block element. It shows variable valency, colored compounds, colored ions, also acts as catalyst. Also acts as catalyst. 2 chromium atoms, 2 Cr, 7 oxygen atoms, 7 oxygen. Oxygen shows minus 2 in case of oxide. 7 of minus 2 equal to its charge. Charge of the given radical is minus 2. That equal to minus 2. 2 Cr minus 14 equal to minus 2. Then we get 2 Cr, 2 chromium atoms equal to plus 12. Then chromium gets plus 6. Chromium gets plus 6. Now the next compound is potassium. Potassium ferrocyanide. It is one of the complex compound. Potassium ferrocyanide. Now in this case, 4 potassium atoms, 1 iron atom, 6 cyanide ions. Then 4 into 1, 4 iron, 6 cyanide. Cyanide may get the charge. In the second one we written already, cyanide radical charge is minus 1. Isocyanide also have the charge minus 1. Then in case of CN, we make it minus 1. 6 of minus 1 equal to 0. 4 minus 6, minus 2. Iron minus 2 equal to 0. Iron minus 2 equal to 0. Then iron may get plus 2 charge. Now in case of dinitrogen trioxide, dinitrogen pentoxide. Dinitrogen trioxide on hydrolysis it may form nitrous acid. Nitrous acid. Dinitrogen pentoxide on hydrolysis it may form nitric acid. Nitrous nitric. Now coming to the charges. All these are the compounds. Now we have to find the nitrogen valency or oxidation number in the given compounds. 2N plus 3 of minus 2. Plus 3 of minus 2 equal to 0. 2N minus 6 equal to 0. The nitrogen may get the charge plus 3. Because of change. As earlier we discussed that nitrogen and oxygen both are electronegative in nature. Now N2O5. 2 nitrogen atoms, 5 oxygen atoms. Oxygen charge is minus 2. Then 2N minus 10 equal to 0. N will get the charge plus 5. Now thiosulfide ion, 2S, already given here, sulfur may get the charge plus 2. Iron, carbon monoxide. Now how many carbon monoxide molecules are there? Penta. Penta, 5 molecules. The underlying element is iron. Now, CO. CO represents carbon monoxide. CO represents carbon monoxide and it is neutral molecule. Actually, non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature, but it is a neutral molecule. Neutral with the charge 0. 5 into 0, 0. Then iron plus 5 of 0 equal to 0. Then iron may get the charge 0. Now, last one, nitrozelium ion. Nitrozelium ion. The charge of the radical is plus 1. Nitrogen is a non-metal, oxide also non-metal. N minus 2 equal to plus 1, N equal to plus 3. That is the charge of the nitrogen, the nitrozelium ion. Now in this session we discuss the what is the radical definition, types, and how can we calculate the oxidation number of that particular ion and radical. It is the subtopic of oxidation number in the main chapter, oxidation and reduction reaction of class 6. Now these are the different examples with the structures, and oxidation number can be found out by the given rules or by the structural method. Now these are the various examples and some frequently asked compounds. From frequently asked compounds with the underlying elements. Thanks for watching.